Okay, so we're going to look at the three parts of doing profiles. Step number one is we have to, again, tell the database that we're going to add some profile information. And to do this, we go to the big web config, the web config for the project, and open that up. And then what we're going to do is add a profile section in here. So you can either copy and paste this one from the example that's out there, or you can just type this in. But let's just take a look at this. So this goes in the system.web section, and again, an easy way to make sure you're in the correct section is go right after the system.web start tag, and that way you're not going to be in the middle of, you know, we don't want to be in the middle of the sitemap. We don't want to be in the middle of this role manager or some of these other things we added, but we want to be between the system.web start tag and the system.web close tag. So again, an easy way to make sure you're there is just go right after the system.web start tag and put it there. So we want to have a profile tag, and you notice it's got a start tag and a close tag, and a properties start and close tag. Those are just something you always have. But the next lines, these are the ones where we say, well, what profile information do we actually want to keep track of? And so in this case, I've said let's keep track of their full name, their phone number, and their age. If we want to add something else, I don't know, what else might we keep track of? Their weight. We're just going to say add and then name equals whatever. And so in the name, this is the profile property that we want to keep track of. And what this does is, think of this as extends our database. So if we want to keep track of the weight, we just put in the weight. And then we also have to add a type. And I've just been doing type equals string for all of these. Again, we could do the different database types if we wanted to, but I think string, I know string always works, so I'm being kind of lazy. So there's all kinds of stuff you could put in here, right? It's just whatever you want, just stick it in here. Rather than making a database table, our own database table, we're just saying extend the table that's here already. And it's uniquely tied to each user's username. So rather than having to do the primary key thing and keep track of that between our tables, it's just done for us. So this is step one. Come into the web config and add whatever profile information you want to keep track of. Then step two, we need to actually get the data from the user. So to do that, you know, we built some of this stuff yesterday, but let's just do it again. We'll build another. So I'm going to add another item in here, call it get user profile info, and the name of the page is nothing special. Then what we'll do is put a couple text boxes on here that the user can put their information in. So grab a text box, and after this I'll put a prompt, and what we said, we want to put in their full name, and then their phone name, their phone age, and weight. Okay, so full name, phone, age, and weight. So I'm just changing the text prompts out here. The other thing I need to change here, though, well, I don't have to change this, but I'm going to just so I can keep track of stuff, is the name of the text box or the ID of the text box, because we're going to have to write a little VB code to say, let's take what the user's put in here and then write it out to the database for them. So I'm going to call this one TXT full name. Call this one TXT phone. TXT age and TXT weight. So that displays my text boxes. And then the other thing I want to put on here is a button to have, you know, say go ahead and write this information. So I'll grab a button, stick it on here, and on here we'll change the text on this to say So if we take a look at this, looks like this, some text boxes and a button. But now here's the part where we actually have to write a little bit of code or copy some code. So what I'm going to do is double-click the button because I want this code to fire off when the user clicks the button. So when I double-click that, it brings me to the VB page for this and into the button click event. And what I want to do now is say, write this. So I think I can remember what this is supposed to be, but I'm going to say profile and then hit the dot, and it shows me in here, it says, hey, I know all the profile information you have for this. So I can choose profile.fullname, and then I'm going to say what I want that to equal is the TXT fullname. Well, what's in the TXT fullname text box? So this is all there is to it. And I'm going to copy this paste or copy this code then and say profile.phone equals whatever's in the phone text box. And then profile dot phone, where we have email. No, not email. Wait. Age and weight, right? Okay. Age. And the order here doesn't matter, right? I'm just dot. Oh, thanks. Dot text. And then profile dot weight. So this will write the profile information, and let's run this. And one of the things that this depends on, though, is that we're logged in. It's going to write this stuff for the currently logged in user. So if I try to write the profile data now, it's saying, hey, you know, anonymous users, you can't keep track of their profile information. You're not logged in. I don't know who you are. So what we want to do first is log in. And we actually most likely would put this in a folder and protect the folder and say only members can change their profile information. Does that make sense? I would not leave this out in a public area. So we'd go back and do the membership stuff. So I would have to have logged in to do this. But let me log in. And I'm back at the profile page. And I can now write stuff in here. My phone is, my age is 52, and my weight is, and I write the profile data. Well, so we can assume that it's written. We notice we're going to get the error. But let's go write another page to read our profile information. So to read the profile information, it's, or you know what, let's just look at the one we already have out here. This display profile information, if we look at the source code on this one, I've got a couple text boxes, one for TXT, full name, phone. Let's just add the ones on here for the age and weight. TXT age and TXT weight. And I'm not going to put the text prompts. And then let's look at the VB code for this one. So when this page loads, right away we're just going to read the profile information. And to read it, we just do the opposite of what we did before. We put the profile on the right-hand side of the equal sign, and this says, go and read the profile information and then stick it in the text box. So we've already got the ones for phone and full name. So for age, change that to that. Change this to profile.age. Change it to TXT weight. So now when we run this, again, I have to be logged in. You know there's nothing there because I'm the anonymous user right now until I log in. But as soon as I log in, it goes and reads my profile information. Grabs it out of there. So we can display this Okay, so that's the three steps, right? Go to web config and say, what do you want to store? Then step two is have some way to put the profile information in there. And step three is to display the profile information.